Now, staying safe online has never been more difficult. Last year alone, Australians lost over a whopping $300 million to scams and cyber criminals. And now these fraudsters have a new target in their sights, our smartphones.
Yeah, here to tell us about the latest scams and how to protect ourselves is tech expert from Tech Guide, Steve Fenech. Steve, it's always great to have you in here. We know that there's plenty of scams online, but now our smartphones, they become the latest battleground.
Yeah, good morning. No, it's right. You think about it, more people have a smartphone than have a computer. Yep. So cyber criminals, it's a numbers game for them. The more people they can target, then that's the better it is, the better result it is for them. So we're seeing scam text messages, a lot of robocalls, even what they call number spoofing. So you're getting a call from what you think is a local mobile number, but it's probably from another country. But you answer that call. I had a call recently and I looked at the number. It actually wasn't too far from my own number. And I answered the call and it was a robocall saying someone's bought something on Amazon in your name. Here's what you need to do. And I immediately knew it was a scam. But it's becoming more common because we've all got, like my mother, who's in her 80s, has got a phone. She doesn't have a computer. So everyone's got a phone. So the scam text messages, I think Telstra even set up a filter back in April. They've already blocked tens of millions of messages before they even get to the device. It's like at the rate of like 1,500 a minute they're blocking. So this is a rampant problem that we just really need to stay vigilant and just don't pay attention to the messages pretending to be from Australia Post. Like I remember during COVID, everyone was ordering online. Here's a way to redirect your delivery. A lot of people fell for that, unfortunately, gave up their details, their addresses, and That was the result.
Yeah, what are the scammers after? What do they want from us?
Well, the currency for scammers is identity, your ID. So if they get your name, your address, all those details, they can build enough points of ID to take out a loan in your name or to take out and create another phone number in your name. So there's even during tax time, if they can get hold of your tax file number, they could even make claims in your name. So it's really that's the what they buy and sell on the dark web. They sell those things, but also of course the result is to make a financial gain. So for you to give up your bank account details or your bank account your credit card details. So I think every message is trying to say to you, look, here's something that's happening. You need to act now and let's fix it. Yeah. The classic example would be the phishing emails that pretend to be from Netflix or your bank to say, well, your account's been frozen, click here to unfreeze it. And then people have gone on and typed in their bank account and their name and account number, password, and given that information straight to a cyber criminal.
So what can we do about it? Because it's difficult to keep up, and especially when they're tailored to certain parts of the year as well. What can we do? Because that's the most important thing.
Yeah, well, that's a good point. Cyber criminals are very opportunistic in terms of the time of year. Like now, it's tax time. There's a lot of phishing scams where they're impersonating the tax office. During COVID, there were some horrible scams that a lot of people got caught where they were imitating companies that were trying to process their JobKeeper payment. So people thinking, great, let's get this going. And it was they were giving their details to someone else.
Yeah.
And they lost their money. They gave up their details. So even during Christmas time where everyone's online, the cyber criminals, it's Christmas for them too, they're all online as well. But the things to look out for, I think you really need to pay attention to the message or text message you get. Often there's no personal reference. It doesn't say, hi, Steve. It doesn't have an account number. Often it's an urgent call to action. They want you to do something, like your account's been compromised, your Netflix account is being disabled. There's action they want you to take. So I think that you also look out for spelling mistakes, bad grammar, because often these come from countries where English isn't their first language. Things like that. Also, they're imitating companies. Like you might get an email that says, you know, Commonwealth Bank or Telstra. So that they've got all the logos. You'd swear it's a real email, but don't click on the links. Go to the sources. Yeah.
My mum actually got a scam email the other day that looked as though the name in the sending was a friend of hers who sends her emails frequently. And it looks really real.
That's really easy to do. But what you do, if you get one of those emails that appears to be from someone you know or from a trusted company, if you go and hover your mouse above that on your computer, it'll reveal the email address behind
it. And
it'll
look dodgy.
And it looks like just total gobbledygook. It won't look like a real email. So that's just one of many things to look out for if that is a phishing email, a scam email, a text message. All those little points, keep all those in mind. That's going to help you stay safe.
Yeah, I think that's the main thing, because it really is gutter stuff. I mean, lowest of the lowest. So for people, if we can remind them, what would be the golden rules to stay safe, both online and on our smartphones?
Well, I think number one, it's funny to say this, don't react. That's what they want you to do. They want you to think, they want you to panic and think something's wrong with your account or something. So they want you to react. Don't do that. That's the first thing they want you to do. If there's any links on that email, if there's any kind of any other thing they want you to do, it's normally through a link that'll either lead you to a site that's imitating that company or to give up your bank details and all that information. But if it is from, say, you get an email from the Commonwealth Bank and you happen to be a Commonwealth Bank customer, go to the Commonwealth Bank website, go to the branch, go to the source. So don't trust the links, don't trust them. Go to that place and check it for yourself.
Great. Yeah. See if you can get them to answer the phone.
Yeah.
Go to the branch. Turn up.
They're on the same line, yeah.
thanks, Steve. Look, that is all really good advice. No worries.